bit more about BETT. For one thing, there's no BETT Radio this year, or not the BETT Radio that we're used to. Russell Prue, who used to do it, he's doing his own radio show, Russell's Sunday Lunch, between 12 and 3 on various local radio stations, but also online, and also I think Mixcloud or somewhere you can find it. I think if you search on Russell Prue Radio, and I'll tweet out some links to it later on. WENOTNO is us, our Twittering. But we'll find ways of finding that. There will be some education within it, but his show is cookery and a lot of music, books, author guests, all sorts of things. But I imagine that education, schools, and that sort of thing will be part of it. Anyway, we'll find out more about the musical part of it, the radio part of it, of what's going on at BETT. There are it seems to be podcasts, a lot of people doing podcasts, which I can understand, but I think radio's still in there somewhere, we like to think. The other things to say then about who is there, trying to stop. I'm looking around at the studio. JD will be in the studio, and I guess Chris and myself will be there at Excel in London on the Thursday, phoning back what we can discover. And I think I'm going to describe it to JD tomorrow as if it was all in this room, which would make it a bit more square rather than oblong. And I'm only talking about one of the halls. There's a hardware hall, which I think is the North Hall, but this would be the South Hall. It looks to be much the same as it was. So in one corner, let's say, there's a head by BETT, which is the universities and the colleges, but also Rapid MOOC, which is a way of doing videos very quickly. There's a fixed camera, excellent microphones and editing screen. It's a really useful bit of kit for producing video. I wouldn't say it's completely foolproof, but they make it look very straightforward. And also Catch, what's it called? I've forgot the name of it, but it's a microphone in a square foam box. I've also seen a teddy bear one. In the school's version, there's an even friendlier version, but this is a square microphone which can be used in seminars or lecture halls, just thrown around the audience, and it's Wi-Fi enabled. There's some magic way by which it ends up in the desk. We could have one of those in this studio, I think. But those two bits of kit, the microphone and the Rapid MOOC, are close to the universities, so I think you've got to have a reasonable budget for those. By the way, the Digital Humanities Lab has got a very good studio on campus here in Exeter, but they're very podcast orientated. I don't think it's used for radio very much, but if anybody knows when it's been used and if some of the content might end up on radio, I have contacted them and they say, well, they don't really know what happens to it. People come and use the studio and then it goes away somewhere, so it's hard to track down where this WAV or MP3 is going. But it would be interesting. Or if anybody knows how to publicise that possibility, because DAB is available on Phonic, for example. It might go on some other station. We do know Access All Aerials are going to be on DAB from November, and there must be other people doing it as well. And so it goes to Plymouth and Torquay, and I think it will go to East Devon at some point. So there may be some people, however they create their podcast or whatever it is, but I think the Digital Humanities Studio, they may not call it a studio. Anyway, I'm going off topic again, but I'm going to kind of stay with it. That's one corner. But then when you get towards the middle bit is where Google and Microsoft and a few other people, Intel, that there's definitely a middle bit to it. And then you get towards the opposite corner and slightly separated, not as close together as they were last year, there's Adobe and what is now Canva. So I think Adobe will be promoting their Express, I think it's still called Express, their AI doing everything, especially social media content options. So they're not promoting their classic Creative Cloud or Photoshop or something on the desktop as in previous years. Whereas last year, what is now Canva, which was Serif, let's say, they actually did have a sort of illustrator and a page design and a photo editing, and they were quite happy with that. They thought it gave designers more scope, and you could pay a fixed amount of money and you could take it away. It was yours to keep. It wasn't demanding a subscription. You didn't wake up one morning and find it had been updated in ways you didn't understand. There were many advantages of it. But whether Canva think the same way, I don't know. But we will discover. That could be one of the things that we'd comment on when we phone in January. And then further out in that corner, there's the BBC with Bite Size. And this is 40 years of BETT that will have happened by next year. And the BBC has been bigger. They have had larger stands at different times. And I don't know what the new government will. I expect they'll turn up, and they do seem a bit more interested in the technology, sharing information. So I think this the question of what data from the education system will be available to the EdTech people. I think that will be discussed, but there might also be discussion what the BBC could offer. Because I think they could possibly do more if somebody encouraged them. But we'll see how all of that goes. And then the other thing, I don't know where it is, but there will be more of a special educational needs SEND village, a space where, as I said, I don't know where, but there does seem to be more interest in that this year than previously, so we'll definitely go and have a look at that, and also look for more on voice and sound, because this is mostly radio that we're talking about.